Morning all, Clive's modelling bench. So, let's do the conning tower. So what I'm going to do with this is, I'm going to spray the dark grey on. So where we have this picture here, and a pointer, just a pointer rather than my big chunky fingers. So what we're going to be doing here is we're going to be doing these bits here. So these dark streaks here. Yeah, this is what we're going to be doing. So I've got the grey. So let's get going. A bit about it on that one. Put a bit of that back in the jar. By the way, The base coat was XF66, that's Terrier. This colour is 503 Mr. Colour. This is a USAF 15 grey. And then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to add this one, 333, extra dark sea grey, just with a hint of black, and this will do everything else. And I mean all the outlining of the camo, and I'm going to put a drop of this in. Tiny hint of black. Four drops of black. And then get the opening of that. Six dark sea grey. A bit thick to me. Try and thin it up a bit. Right, let's put the caps back on. This is going to be the real bloody tricky part. Use this brush, give it a quick stone. Wipe them stuff down. Right. See if I can do this on the screen. God, blimey. It's not easy. Getting somewhere like that, isn't it? About pins and needles in your arm. Oh, must have trapped a nerve or something. Have to shake the blood back in it. God, jeez. The good thing about this is that when you do this, outline is, like I said, it's a bit thick. You can actually go in the inner bit. So, you know, if you think you cocked it up, like I have there, then you can always go back and do it again. Where's this bit come from? So that's gone, not you. The camouflaging done there, like that. There's a rough example. Yep, a couple of little bits have gone wrong there. And, God, bloody hell, bloody fingers. And then it's a case of, mottling all them as well. Not a problem. We just chuck that in the extra dark sea grey. It's a case of all of this here has to all be mottled up as well, so it's up at this tonight. Really tiny squiggles. So I'll get an empty jar of this. I'll tip that paint into there because I know that's the blacked out paint that I need. Give the old airbrush a quick sluice out. Quick clean out by this jollop, this leveller, thinners. Now you've got to do all the tiny little irritating dots with this. Now I'll have to have a look on the old three reference books I've got and see if there's anything on there as to whether those little camouflage dots were actually sprayed on or painted on. I don't know, they might have been painted on. Tighten that up a bit. Let them go back in there. I don't need that. And then, what's I do? I just go five, won't it? One of these is really thin. Chuck that in there. I don't think it's this one. Might need a bit of a. Yeah, I don't know. Right, then what we do here. Oops. Everywhere. Right, let's back to it. So, now when I was saying we're all cocked up, sorry, I've gone a bit thick with the lines, you can actually go back over this. Can go over it again like that, and you can thin the stripes out. Whoops, like that. So where they might look a bit thick, you can go back over them. It makes it look a bit more palatable, I suppose. And then now what I've got to do now is with this colour, which I didn't do before, is put him aside. And yeah, I think I've got to do all these here. Yeah. I think it's just the top. What's going on this bloody thing? Yeah, so the whole deck. So again with this colour, just doing the whole deck. So when you're doing this side, where you don't want to get it on here, just spray down along the edge. It doesn't matter what you do, you're not going to get it on the, and it's the same with this side as well. You see like that, turn him down. Put the old aerial down or whatever that thing is. It's like a security camera, but I don't think it is. Well, it's not, no, I know it's not. And then what you do there. That's it. And then tipsy a bipsy a bit more in. And then that's just to do the arse end. Sit down like that. Right, let me do a quick blast over the back of there. That's it, right, we're out of juice. So that's done the whole thing. Right, so that's all done. So now what I've got to do now is just do the hole, but the main point was to show you how to do the conning tail. Guys, I'm putting some light here. There. That's better. Now you can see it for us. Better colours now. Better lighting. Change the colour of the bloody bulb and there you go. So that's the markings. Now all I've got to do now is with the same dark colour, just go over it and pepper it with all these things. Now there is a mask and I have got it. It was to do with weathering. And it's like a little pattern mask, but where the heck it is, I don't know. Because I've moved into this temporary accommodation, everything's just, you know, gone tits up. whoops. So, yeah, but anyway, that gives you an insight on how to do that. I've sprayed the top, we've done the side, sprayed the top. There's no camo on the side here, on this particular one. But, yeah, now all I've got to do is mask it up and do the bottom. So I shall see you in another video. And if I have found that card, I'll do that. If not, I'll have to try and somehow do that whole thing freehand. But I must admit, I'm not looking forward to doing that patterning on that in freehand because it is quite something else. But we'll give it a go because I'm always up for a good challenge. Might have a quick practice first off screen. Good-o. Like and subscribe. See you soon, guys and girls. Take care.